Hello girls, Mr. Betcher here, and I want to take you through your first lesson in Scratch so you can get started on understanding what Scratch is all about. Some of you may have played with this before, but that's okay. We're going to kind of start from the beginning just to refresh your memory and for anyone who hasn't done it before. So I'm here on the PLC homepage, the Enable homepage, and what I'm going to do is scroll down just a little bit, and you'll actually see there's a button here that says Scratch, and you can just click that button and it will take you to the Scratch homepage. Now, if you want to go to this some other way, if you're at home, for example, and you just want to go directly there, there's the address there, scratch.mit.edu. And MIT actually stands for Massachusetts Institute of Technology. It's a big university near Boston in America, and they're the people who make Scratch. So that's the address, scratch.mit.edu. All right, let's get started. Now, if you haven't watched it already, I'd really recommend you watch this little movie here. I'm not going to play it right this second, but when you go and log in and get to this page, click that little button, watch the movie. It only goes for about a minute. Otherwise, maybe your teacher can show it to you as a class. But it's definitely worth having a look at that. When you're ready to start, you can either click the Create button up on the top here, or you can click this green thing that says Try It Out. They both take you to the same place. So let's go Create. And this is Scratch. Right, now I'm going to just take you through a little tour around here first so you know what's in here. Let me just close this and show you. So there are four main areas of the screen. There's this part up here. This is called the stage, and the stage is where everything happens. So when you write your programs and write your games or whatever it is you're making, this is where they play out here. Underneath that, this is where the characters, or the sprites, the correct term is sprite, you can put sprites into your game. So right now we have one sprite, it's a picture of a cat, and we can do things with the cat. But if I wanted more sprites, there are buttons here, so you can see there are four ways of adding sprites. One is to pick from a library. If I click that button there, you'll see I've got a whole bunch of sprites to pick from. So let's add a second one. We've got a cat, let's get a dog. Okay, so I click on the dog and say OK, and you can see now I have two sprites. So that's one way to add a sprite. The second way you can add a sprite is to click the paintbrush and actually draw your own sprite. So, you know, if you were a bit of an artistic type of person, you could draw a very rough animal. Like, so, I don't know what that is, maybe a cow. Moo. Okay, I'm actually not going to keep that. So, if you don't want a sprite, you can right click on it and say delete and get rid of a sprite that way. Okay, so there's different ways you can add sprites. The next way is if you've actually got a sprite in a file, you can do that, or you can take a photograph and turn a photograph into a sprite, turn yourself into a sprite. Okay, but this is the sprite area. Also, just on the side here is the backdrop. So just like you can change, you can add sprites, you can also add backdrops. So if I click on this area here, and the same sort of buttons I've got underneath that one, click on there and I can choose, say, this desert and go OK, and you can see that now I've got a desert background. Alright, so that's how you change all your characters and backgrounds around. The next area is this area in the middle here, and this is where you actually do we'll actually find all of the controls and the commands that you get to use. So you can see it has three panels: scripts, costumes, and sounds. Let's just take a look at scripts to start with. There are different categories and they're color-coded, so if you're looking for something and you know it's color, you can look in the correct category. Anything to do with moving a sprite around will be in this motions area. Anything to do with a sound, for example, will be in sounds. If you're, say, two sprites bumping into each other, that would be sensing, when they sense each other. So you pick the category according to what you want to do. In the middle is costumes. So each sprite has a number of costumes, and you can see our cat here has two costumes, and you see if I switch between them, you can see that the cat is actually, it's one character but different costumes. They call them costumes. Same with the dog. If I look at the dog has three costumes. And you can use these costumes to sort of animate the dog and make it look like it's walking, even though it's just one character. And the final thing is sounds. You can attach a sound. So in this one, there's a dog sound attached to the dog. And you can see if I switch to the cat, I get a different sound, a cat sound. So sprites, scripts, costumes, sounds, they're the three main things you need to work with when you're dealing with sprites. over here in this large grey area, this is where all the action happens. This is actually where you write your programs. So the idea is if you want one of your sprites to do something, you can take a block, these are called blocks, and drag them out here and assemble them in order. So if I want my cat, say, to move, let's say I want my cat to move 50 steps, and then I might get my cat to wait for a second, and maybe then say something, maybe say hello. Okay, now I've just clipped those little blocks together, and if to run them, there's a number of ways you can do this, but the simplest way is just double click them. If I double click that block, it will make that set of instructions run, and you can see the set of instructions apply to the cat, not the dog. So I'll double click this, moves 50 steps, waits a second, says hello. All right, let's just try a similar one with the dog. Let's get the dog, and what can the dog can let's make the dog point in the other direction. So instead of pointing to the right, let's point to the left. So the dog will turn the other way. And let's make the dog say hello, and also make the dog play the sound of the dog. All right, so let's run this one. Oh, look at that, the dog's gone upside down. We need to fix that. There's a little information arrow here. I'll click that one and I'll just say the rotation style. I don't want the dog rotating around. I want the dog to face left or right only. So there you go, problem fixed. All right, so that's how that works. So your task for today is to open up Scratch, create yourself a couple of sprites, add yourself a background, and then make them do something interesting. And it can be anything you like. As an example, I'd say, why don't you make your sprite to do a dance? And just see what you can come up with. You probably also want to also just control things like, if you want things to repeat, so you can get things to repeat by dragging the repeat loop around there like that. So if we run that, that happens pretty quick, doesn't it? It's like a rapping dog. We may need to go in and slow that down a little bit. So after we play the sound, let's wait a second before we do it again. Okay? Let's stop that with the red stop sign up here. So there's a whole bunch of interesting things you can go and explore today by combining motions, looks, sound. You'll probably need some controls. And you may want an event as well. You may want to do something like when you click the green flag up here, that's what starts your program. So to start this, click the green flag, and I'll stop it. All right, so there's some things you can work on today, and see how you go.